Welcome to a new edition of the Neon Jazz Interview Series with legendary Pittsburgh sax cat Richie Cole as he talks about his newest 2019 CD teamed up with the great Hammond B3 veteran Tony Monaco. It's called The Keys of Cool, and it's another great testament to his stature as a giant in the jazz world, and this duo is fantastic. He talks about their unique collaboration, where the songs came from, the future of touring, and so much more. So please get to know Richie and dig this interview, my friends.
Okay, Richie, hey, thank you for taking a minute out for Neon Jazz today. Thank you for sending over the new music. Man, I always love it when I get Richie Cole in the mail.
My pleasure, my man. It's a pleasure to be on Neon Jazz.
Right on. So let me talk to you a little bit about this brand new album, brand new collaboration with Tony. This sounded like the language that was going on in this album just sounded like sheer pleasure. Talk to me a little bit about how it felt.
Well, I kind of grew up with jazz trios back in New Jersey, in the urban belt there. And I always liked working with the sound of the Hammond organ. So it was a great traditional jazz sound from like the 60s, you know, and we kind of wanted to bring that sound back.
Talk to me a little bit about What was the overall vision with this? I mean, you start with I Remember Jimmy, and you're going through all kinds of songs that just have a great feel to it. What was kind of the artistic vision for this process?
I talked to Tony about it, and I said, Tony, you bring a few songs, I'll bring a few songs, and let's do some traditional organ songs like Canadian Sunset and songs like that from that period of time. And we kind of put together, I think, kind of a classic 60s organ trio sound. And I was thrilled to have Tony be involved. It's the first time that Tony and I ever met. I knew about him for quite a while. And he lives in Columbus. I live in Pittsburgh, so we're not that far away. But he travels a lot, and I travel a lot. Not as much as I used to, because I'm getting older, and I broke some bones over the last couple of years. But so we finally found time to get together, and Mark Luke is a great guitar player from Pittsburgh here, and Reed Horson, a hell of a drummer from Pittsburgh, and we kind of put it together at a great studio. So it came out good. We did it in two sessions, and that was it.
I love the title of Waltz for a Rainy Bebop Evening. Talk to me a little bit about how this title came about.
Yeah, I wrote that song when I was working at a place called Harold's House of Jazz down in Washington, D.C. in 1976. And I wrote a lot of songs during that period of time, New York Afternoon and Remember Your Day Off and Keeper of the Flame. And Harold had his... Harold's House of Jazz was kind of in a basement, like you would have in a jazz club in Paris or something like that. And I remember being down there all by myself, and it was raining outside. I'm sitting at the piano. I had nothing else to do. And I just sat down at the piano and came up with that song. It took me about 10 minutes.
Right on. When the listener and fan goes out and buys this CD or downloads this CD, what do you want them to get from this when they listen to it over and over? How do you want them to feel?
Well, I want them to feel good. I want them to feel happy. There's nothing on there that's too far out at all. You know, there's, you know, jazz is a big word. There's all kinds of styles of jazz, some of which I'm not crazy about, you know. Some of the real avant-garde stuff, it doesn't do much for me except kind of irritate me or confuse me. But, you know, some of it I like. But, you know, it's like I say, it's a big four-letter word, jazz. It's like the word food, you know. There's everybody doesn't like every kind of food. People have certain preferences. And, you know, I hope the people who prefer this kind of sound will enjoy it. And then that's my mission is accomplished. Now I'm on to my next project.
So are you guys going to perform this live? Do you have a slate of places you're going to go to?
Well, we haven't yet, because Tony's been on the road. Actually, I worked with Tony at a place called Nighttown in Cleveland about a year or so ago, and we played together there. But that was before we did the record. That's when we were just kind of coming up with some ideas about what we were going to record.
Well, hey, Richie, thank you for catching up with me with the new material. I'm looking forward to spending it on Neon Jazz. And, man, good luck with everything.
Hey, I really appreciate it, my man, and thank you for calling me, and I hope to get to Kansas City again sometime. It's been a long time since I've been there.
Oh, man, we'd love it, for sure.
Thanks for listening and tuning in to another Neon Jazz interview, where we give you a bit of insight into the finest players in New York, Kansas City, Pittsburgh, and spots all over the world, giving fans all that jazz. And thanks to Richie for his time, music, and stories. If you want to hear more interviews, go to Famous Interviews with Joe Domino in the iTunes Store. Visit NeonJazz at YouTube.com, and for everything Neon Jazz all the time, go to the NeonJazz.blogspot.com. Until next time, enjoy the jazz, my friends.
Neon Jazz.